morning. Day 14 already, it's going fast. Welcome. I'm full of energy for some reason today. So, looking forward to doing a strong practice. So get your mat ready, Monday morning. Let's work. Get yourself situated while I just double check that everything is working here. You can start in a child's pose. Something weird today with Facebook, I don't know. I hope that you're all able to yes. Okay. Everything seems to be working. I still don't think I'm used to this whole thing. It's such a strange thing to do, to talk to you guys that I know are there. So, if you're just joining, come to a child's pose. I'm just dealing with some computer stuff here. Child's pose. So let's wiggle the back a bit, wiggle the hips side to side, let the head roll side to side. Gently waking up the body. Shoulders one by one. Walking your elbows in, walking your hands closer to your knees. Swaying your back side to side. Coming to sitting upright. Roll your shoulders one by one. Reversing the direction. Then roll them both together back to front. Reverse the direction. Front to back. Take your elbows. Opening the chest on the way up. Reversing. And then walking your hands into all fours. Start swaying side to side, leaning into the shoulders one by one. Let the head react to that.
let the hips react to that. And then keep going. Turn your palms so your fingers face you. Palms flat on the floor. And then keep moving side to side. Move your hips slightly back. Increasing the stretch on your wrists. And then putting the backs of your hands on the floor, wrists forward, fingers towards you. Keep your hips and shoulders moving side to side. Stretch, move the hips further back. Just gently opening up the hands. If it's too much for you, put the hands closer by. And put the palms flat. And start to lift the wrists. Pelvis can stay still now. Strengthening the wrists and stretching the back of the fingers. Let that go. Tuck your toes in. Lift your knees gently off the floor. Not high, very low. Activating the core. And start to gently move back and front with the knees off the floor. And while you do that, start rolling the shoulders, reverse the direction of the shoulder roll. Feels a bit like a choo-choo train, this. Into the hands to come sitting on your heels. Use your fingers to point your small toes forward. Open the feet and then circle your hips on top of that. Warming up the whole body gently. If you want to increase this stretch on the feet, lean a bit on your hands, so lean a bit back. Reverse the circles with the hips. And walking your hands back forward, pushing into a squat position with the legs quite close together. So if the heels don't touch the floor, that's fine. It's more about the rounding over of the back. Let your whole back be round. And same thing, start to circle here. So the weight is moving from your right ball of your toe to your right hand, to your left hand, to the left ball of the foot, circling between those four points and reversing, keeping the back round. Knees are circling, shoulders circling. Increase the size of the knee circles. Heels and circle there. You can lean on your fingertips so you have a bit more height here. Circle the knees. Reverse the direction of the circles. And then slowly bring the heels back down. Hang over for a moment. And then start to straighten your legs. Don't straighten them all the way. Keep your knees a little bit bent. Hang over. And then start to circle the knees here. Small, gentle circles. Reverse the direction. Towards the outside, so left, right, circling in opposite directions of each other, then reverse. Circles are moving inwards, one by one. Let go. So the knees are still bending, but now they're reacting to the movement of the hips. Circles of eight with the hips, figures of eight, reversing the direction. And keep those figures of eight in the hips and slowly start to round up the back. Back is swaying side to side. Reverse again the direction. A few times. And then let the movement come into the shoulders. So your shoulders are rolling one by one. And then start to twist the upper body. Movement starts from the floor. Moves up into the ankles, knees, hips, shoulders, and the head comes last. Slowly let it go. Standing still. Roll your head down, shoulders down, hips tilt, hands reach the floor. Walk your hands forward into a downward dog. Spread your fingers out. Push through the finger pad, so the place where your hand meets your fingers, the base of your fingers in your hand palm. Sway your hips side to side, walk through the feet, let your neck relax. Thank you. to a still downward dog. Sending your heels towards the floor. Sit bones in opposition of your heels coming towards the ceiling. Bend your knees to roll up through the spine. One deep breath at the top. Dropping the shoulders down on the out breath and taking the hands up. Breathing in. Diving forward. Come halfway up. Breathing out, stepping into plank. Five breaths here to wake up your plank. You can make circles through the shoulders, hips, heels. Maybe lifting up one hand after the other to position them back in a way that feels good to you. Toes, leave the knees on the floor, push up. Come into a downward dog. Then lift your right foot parallel, foot flex. Relaxing through the neck. Point through your right foot. Pull the knee into the chest and take your foot back to the same position, flex. It was one of five. More. point your foot and open your hip, lift the leg more. Then bend the knee, pull the knee into the chest. Put your foot down between your hands. Drop your left knee, untuck the toe. Leaning with the hands on your right knee. Waking up the hips. Gentle circles. Or whatever feels good here. Maybe a bit forward and backward motion. Left toes under and straighten your back knee. Bring your hands down. Foot, step into plank. Try to round it down either with the knees to the floor or with straight legs. Small cobra or upward dog. Coming into downward facing dog. The weight equally divided between the hands. Then point through the left foot. Pull the knee into the chest, all the way forward, weight coming over the wrist, and then push back. Leg comes back to the same position. 3 more times. Point through the foot, open your hip to lift the leg a bit higher. And then pull the knee into the chest, foot between the hands, drop your right knee down, lean on the right knee with the hands. Slight movements to wake up the hips. Open your arms, lift them to the ceiling, tuck your right toes, straighten the right leg. Open up your hands to put them down next to your foot, step into plank, coming down into upward facing dog, downward facing dog. Looking up at the hands to step back towards your hands. hands with your feet. Coming halfway up with the back and rounding down. Bend the knees to roll up the back. Lifting the arms overhead. Breathing in, lifting your face and chest. And diving down. Come halfway up. And now you can step or jump into plank. Come down into chaturanga. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Twisting down, dropping the foot towards the floor. Weight comes onto the left hand. See if you can balance for a moment on the left foot, left hand. Place the right foot down, stay on the ball of the foot. Open your chest to the ceiling. Come back the same way, lifting your foot off already before your head comes down to challenge your balance. Back into downward dog splits. Come up into the ball of your left foot 5 times. And then pull your right knee into the chest. Put your foot between your hands. Straight up into Warrior One. Opening up into Warrior Two, the left heel comes to the floor. Arms are long. And straighten from the knee. Drop your left arm down towards the leg. Flip the right palm up, lift it over the ceiling, over your head. Breathing in, lifting your ribcage up and gently bending back. Keep the back there, bend your front knee. And then windmill the arms all the way down. Come to the ball of your left foot. Step back into plank. Chaturanga down. Upward dog. Downward facing dog. Lift the right foot off. The left foot, sorry. Lifting the left foot. Point through that foot and open the hip. Lifting the leg higher. Then bend the knee, drop the foot. And then start to send the foot towards the floor. Moving your weight forward onto the right hand. Lifting the arm, left arm before your foot comes down. Opening your chest to the ceiling. Staying on the left ball of your foot. Coming back the same way. Try to lift your foot before your hand comes down. Challenging your back into downward dog splits. Coming onto the ball of your right foot 5 times. Then pull your knee into your chest. Step your foot between your hands. Come into warrior one. Opening the arms into warrior two. Dropping your right heel down. Straighten your front knee. Drop your right arm down to the back of your leg. Flip the left palm up, lift the arm, lift the chest, bend over gently. Keep breathing. Stay there with the back, bend your front knee. And then windmill your arms all the way back down to the floor. Turn your right leg in. Step into plank. Downward dog. Chaturanga down. Into downward dog. Looking up at your hands, step or jump flat to the front of your mat, halfway up, rolling down, bend through the knees to roll up the back, so we're going to keep repeating this flow and every time add a little bit more to it. So we'll flow a little bit faster through the beginning and leave out the heel lifts and stuff like that. Then we're just going to keep adding to the sequence. Breathing in. Lift your arms overhead. Out. Swan dive forward. In halfway up. Out. Step or jump. On the same out-breath, down into chaturanga, in, upward dog, out, downward dog. Next in-breath, lifting your right foot up, opening the hip, dropping the foot down, come into your wild thing right away. Just one breath in, then coming back the same way. Down dog splits, knee into chest, step between your hands. Warrior one, opening to warrior two, straightening the front leg, coming into a back bend. Bending the knee, opening the hands up. Now, next step, put your right hand on the inside of your right foot. Open your left hand to the ceiling. And then straighten your front knee. Look down at your foot, drop your hand, come back into lunge, turning your left foot in, step into plank, chaturanga down, upward dog, downward dog. With that optional push-up in the middle, you can always leave that one out if it gets too much. Lifting up the left foot, pointing the foot, opening the hip, dropping the foot down, coming into your wild thing right away, opening the chest, coming back into your down dog splits, knee into your chest, foot down, warrior one, into warrior two, straightening the leg, bending back, bending the leg, windmill arms, left hand down, inside left foot, facing up, straightening the front knee. Looking down at your foot, dropping both hands, lifting them to put them over on the sides of your foot. Turn your right leg in, lunge, step back, chaturanga down. Upward dog. Into downward dog. Looking up at your hands, step or jump back, halfway up, rounding down, bend your knees to roll up, breathing in, lifting your arms overhead, rounding down, halfway up. Step or jump. Right away, lifting the right foot, pointing through the foot, opening the hip, dropping into, wild thing. Right away, back. Knee to the chest, step the foot, warrior one, warrior two, bending back with a straight leg, bending the leg, windmilling, hand comes to the inside of the foot, straightening the leg. Now bend the knee, come back into warrior two. Now we're going to lift the back heel up, turn it, and twist the arms so you're in opposition. Drop the right arm to the left back of the leg. Flip the left palm up. Arch balance here. Open the arms back down. Put the weight onto the ball of your left foot. Reach your left arm down. Step your foot a little bit in and lift the left leg. Your right arm is still up if you can. turning to the right. Bending the right knee, facing down. Try not to fall. Step back into lunge. And then step your foot back. Chaturanga down. Up dog. Downward facing dog. Three breaths here. Lifting the right foot, the left foot. Left foot comes up, pointing through the foot. Open up the hip. Drop the foot down. Come into wild thing. Open the chest up. Moving back. Down dog splits. Knee into the chest. Foot between the hands. Warrior one. Into warrior two. Bending back with a straight front leg. Bending that front leg. Open the arms, left arm to the inside of your left foot. Opening the face, straightening the knee. Bending the knee, coming back into warrior two. Twisting the arms, coming onto the ball of your right foot, opposition arms, legs. Drop your left arm to the back of your right leg. Arching up gently. And then open the arms back out. Reach your right arm down. Come to the ball of your right foot. Shift your foot a little bit in. Lifting the right leg up. And then opening the left arm more. Looking up at the ceiling. Bend the left leg. Step into a lunge. Let the hands come next to the foot. Plank. Flow. Three breaths. Looking up at the hands, stepping or jumping. Halfway up, rolling down. Rolling out through the back. One deep breath. Lifting your arms up, stretching out of your waist, swan dive down. Lifting halfway up, step or jump. Three breaths in, downward dog. So we're doing the same flow and adding a step at the end. Right foot lifting up, pointing through, hip opening, drop the foot into wild thing. Moving back, down dog splits, knee to chest. Step the foot, warrior one, warrior two,
Bending back, straightening the knee. Stay there, bend the knee. Windmill arms. Right hand inside, right foot. Opening the shoulders. Straightening the knee. Bending the knee back. Warrior two. Twisting the arms. All the way to the left comes forward. Pull the arms out. And then drop the right arm back. Arching here. Move the arms back. Shift the weight. Lifting the left leg. Twisting the right arm open. Now, drop your right arm down. Open up your left hip. Flex the foot. Open the left arm. Drop the left hand down. Bend the right knee. Pull the left knee into the chest so the left foot doesn't come down. Rolling up, grabbing your knee. Pull it to your chest. Grab the foot. Come into a tree pose. Through your right knee, arching your back, rolling down, and then shift so that you're left foot can come down. Don't put it down on the floor. Step back into a lunge. Into plank. Vinyasa flow. Three breaths here. Lifting the left foot up, pointing, open the hip, drop the foot down, come into your wild thing, reversing, knee to the chest, put the foot down, warrior one. Warrior two, bending back, bending the leg, hand inside foot, right hand opening to the ceiling, straightening the leg, bending the leg, warrior two. Twisting, lifting the right heel, keep twisting, drop the left arm, lift the right, opening the arms, reaching the right hand front, shifting the weight, lifting the right foot, opening to the left wall.
that left hand. Open the right hip, flex the foot. Open the right arm. Drop the hand back down. Without putting the right foot to the floor, bend both knees. Roll up, grabbing onto your right knee. Pull it into your chest. Straightening through the standing leg. Then grab the ankle from into a tree pose. Your butt, placing the right elbow on the right knee, rounding all the way down, putting your hands on the floor, straightening through the left knee, dropping the head. And then shifting your knee down so you can release the foot. Don't put it on the floor. Bring it around your leg. Step it into lunge. Step into plank. Flow. Looking up at your hands, step or jump back, halfway up, rolling down, bending through the knees, rolling up the spine, deep breath, lifting the arms, swan back down, halfway up. Step or jump. Up dog. Down dog. Right away, left foot up. Still repeating the same sequence. Flowing through all the movements. You can take a bit of a free timing here. You know what's coming next. Take it as your breath allows you. From the warrior three, bending down, not putting the left foot down, pulling the knee into the chest, opening into tree, here let's open the arms up to the ceiling to come sitting down. bringing the arms down to the foot, straightening through the standing leg, dropping the head, shifting. Keep the foot lifted. Now come into standing splits from here. So you can push from these hands on the floor, or grab the back of your right ankle with your right hand so you have a bit more space to pull your torso down, so lift your leg up more. And let your foot come down, bending the right knee, coming down parallel, 1 meter step, straightening through your front leg, rolling over that leg. Open to the side wall. Turn your foot facing forward, your feet facing forward. Grab onto the outside of your ankles, stretching down. Release the hands, walk the hands over to the left. Right arm, right hand into the left diagonal front corner. Left hand holding onto the left heel, dropping the head. Releasing that, walking the hands back. Turning your feet back to the front, coming into a lunge. Step your foot back into plank. Chaturanga down, upward dog. Extra push-up if you can, down or facing dog. Right away, lifting the left foot up, opening hip, same flow. Wild thing. Twisting, twisting. Coming out of the warrior three, both knees bent. Don't put your right foot down. Pull the knee into the chest. Open into tree pose. Then open the arms to move up to bend your left knee. Slowly bending over, reaching to the floor, straightening your standing leg, drop the head, shimmy your foot to Let your foot come down. Don't put it down on the floor. Turn it around your standing leg and then come into standing splits. Leaning your weight into your hands. Or stepping your right hand slightly more forward, pulling your left hand around your left ankle, pulling the weight of the torso down more. Then dropping the right leg, 1 meter step, rounding over. Opening both feet to the side. You can widen the step a little bit if it's hard for you to reach the heels. Grabbing the heels from behind, pulling to stretch your legs. Let go of the grip, walking your hands to the right side, left arm walks, hand walks into the right front diagonal, grabbing your right heel with your right hand, drop your head, letting go of the grip, walking your feet back to the left foot, turning back to the front into a lunge, stepping into plank, chaturanga down, upward facing dog, come into a child's pose, open your knees a little bit, release your forehead into the floor. Soften your jaw. Coming through all fours into downward dog. Looking up at your hands, stepping or jumping back. Halfway up, rolling down. Gently rolling up. I'd like to do the same sequence one more time with a little bit more time, and I just want to add one more position after the tree. And then after that we'll slow down, we'll go to the floor and do some more deeper stretches. So breathing in, lifting your arms up, out, swan diving down, in, halfway up, out, stepping or jumping back, chaturanga down, upward facing dog, enjoy this opening of the chest. Back into downward facing dog. Lifting the leg, make sure you enjoy all the stations on the way, opening the hip, then bending the knee, dropping the foot down. Coming into wild thing, really opening the chest. Coming back. Pulling the knee into the chest first, then rolling through the spine. Step your foot down. Come into a warrior one, strong. Hands can flare. Opening into warrior two. Hips are sinking down. Straightening the knee. Coming into a back bend, and maybe by now you can bend down a little bit more. Dropping the head, opening the throat. And bending the knee. Back into warrior two. Pulling your arms out of the shoulder sockets. And then reaching the right arm down. Inside of the right foot. Opening your hand. Lifting your hand up, pulling out of your shoulder. Straightening the front knee. Let's add a bind here for those that would like. Dropping your right arm behind your leg. Left arm folding behind your back. Clasping the hands. Opening up the shoulder. And keep the bind. Bend your knee. Unclasp the hands. Come into warrior two. Twisting, lifting the left heel. Keep twisting. Drop the right arm to the back of the left foot. Flip the left palm up. Arching back. Use that right hand to walk further down the leg. Opening the throat. Moving back. Reaching the left arm down in front. Pushing through the left foot. Shimmy. Lift the left leg up parallel. Opening the face to the right. Dropping the right arm down. Open up the left hip, flex the foot. Open the left arm to the side wall. Maybe lifting up your right hand. Balancing. Then bend both knees, but keep your left foot off the floor. Pulling your knee towards your chest, grabbing that knee, rolling up. Big strength through your standing leg here. Pulling that knee into the chest, grabbing the ankle. Drop the knee into tree pose. If the foot slips, just hold on to it. Dropping the arms open to the side to open them up overhead. Sit down into a chair. Leaning, reaching your hands slowly to the floor. Bending over. with your legs still in tree pose. Now, here's the change to the sequence. So gently roll back up. Grab that foot. Move it to the outside. And then grab your ankle from the inside. So we're still on our right standing leg, building a lot of strength. Holding the left ankle from the inside. Reach the right arm up, breathe in and reaching the shoulder up, and then kicking the left foot into the hand, coming into dancer pose. Kick the foot up, 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 up. And now move your right arm down. Reach the floor. Let go of the leg, come into your standing splits, grabbing the right heel from behind, straightening through the left leg, drop your head down. Then dropping the leg down, put it parallel, walk your hands back. Weight in the middle between your two feet, hips both facing forward, rounding down over your right leg. That right standing leg did a lot of work. Now give her a stretch. Walking over to the left, turning your feet both facing the left wall. Take your heels slightly out, grabbing onto the back of the heels, stretching. Walk your hands to the right. Right arm. Walking as far as possible into the left front diagonal corner. Dropping the head. You can pull with your left hand on your left heel. Stretching through the right armpit. Then reach that left arm to the front, open it up, twisting. Drop it back down, walk your hands back to the right foot, turning both your feet, come into a big lunge. Let's drop the left knee down. Turn your right foot so it opens to the side. Lift your hands off, clasp your hands behind your back. Pull the hands down towards the floor and open up your chest. Releasing the throat. Roll back up. Step your foot back in. Straighten through the left leg. Step into plank. Chaturanga down. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. And we have the last side of this challenging sequence. Lifting the left foot up, take your time, point through the foot, lift up the hip, drop the foot down. Now really see if you can shift the weight into one foot, one hand. Come into Wild Thing, opening up. Back into your downward dog splits. Then the knee pulls into the chest first. Then you roll through your back, rounding, stepping your foot down. Strong warrior one. Into warrior two. Straightening the front knee, coming to your back bend, deepening it, dropping the head, opening the throat, bending the knee. Warrior two, putting the left hand down. Opening the right, straightening the left leg, and then if you'd like, come into a bind, left arm behind the left leg, right arm behind the back, hands find each other. Opening shoulder, right shoulder up, then bending through the left knee. Unbind, coming into warrior two. Twisting all the way, all the way, all the way. Dropping your left arm down, lifting your right arm, arching back. Coming out of it, shifting the weight forward, reaching with the right hand. Lifting the right leg up, straightening through the left, open to the side. Twisting here, drop your left hand, flex your foot, open your right hip, and then open your right arm to the side. Maybe balancing by lifting your torso up higher, your left hand comes just off the floor. Then bending both knees, not dropping the right foot down, grabbing your right knee, rolling up through the back, pulling the right knee to the chest, strongly straightening through the left knee, then grabbing the right ankle, dropping the knee into a tree pose. If your foot slips here, keep holding on to the foot. Otherwise, prayer in front of your chest. Then open the hand palms to the sides. Lift them overhead. Sit down in a chair. Hands are starting to reach forward and down until they reach the floor. Straighten your standing leg, dropping your head down. Inserting dancer pose here. Bending through the left knee to roll back up. Lifting your ankle off. And then your right palm is facing out and grabbing the right ankle from the inside. Still standing on that left standing leg, lifting the left arm, breathing in, lifting the chest and starting to kick the right foot into the hand. Your back only starts to move because your foot cannot kick up any higher. Slowly coming down, balancing, pulling your left arm out and forward. Kick, few more seconds. And then drop your left hip slowly down. Release the foot. Come into your standing splits. Dropping your right leg down to the floor, turning it parallel. Walking your hands back, put weight into the right heel, round over your left leg. Opening both feet to the right side. And then opening your heels a little bit wider than your toes. Grab onto the back of your heels, straighten through the knees. And flatten out your lower back to pull down. Release the left hand, walk it into the diagonal right corner as far as possible, then drop the head down, stretching through the left armpit. Opening the right arm over the front, twisting towards the ceiling. And drop it back down. Walk your hands back to the left. Turn your feet, coming to a lunge. Drop your right knee, open the left foot and knee, pushing off, clasping the hands behind the back. Try to put the other thumb on top, the one that feels unhabitual. Straighten through the elbows, pull your wrists down, open the chest, drop your head down. Surrender to this pose. If you want to increase the stretch, pull your hands further back. Slowly come out of that. Put your hands down on the floor. Turn your foot back in. Lift your right knee, step into plank. Last chaturanga. Upward dog. And come into a child's pose. Open up your knees as wide as is comfortable for you. side of your mat, as in come with your face on the side of your mat and start to open your knees up into a froggy. And we're doing this like this so that your knees are not on the floor, but actually, if you have some pillows, an even better way to do it would be to have two pillows under your knees in a way that they can slide. Do you want pillows? Position. And just take a moment to move around a little bit in this, relaxing the pelvic floor. See if you can come down to the elbows. Move a little bit back in front. It can be very intense, this stretch. Is it intense for you? Your weight back on your hands and start to window wipe your legs very slowly. So if you have pillows that are sliding on the floor, it can be quite helpful actually. Close your feet together, push your weight a bit back so your knees are slightly in front of your hips, and come back into your child's pose. Thank you. And gently walk yourself out. And then come to sitting either on a block or on your pillows. If you're very flexible, and this is very easy for you, you don't need to use a block here actually. Sitting in a butterfly position with your feet quite close to your pelvis. The block can help, or the pillows can help to roll the pelvis forward. So tilting your sit bones off the block a little bit. But again, if your hips are very open and your knees fall down easily, you don't need to use a block. For me, it's very helpful to have the pelvis slightly higher than the heels. And then using the hands to open up the feet. Heels are touching outside of the feet. They're touching, but you're pulling your balls towards the ceiling, balls of the feet towards the ceiling. Give a little massage here to your feet. Putting some weight on your ankles also. Signaling your hips to relax by sending a bit of kindness into your feet. And then grabbing hold of the ankles. Tilting your pelvis forward. Moving your elbows a little bit out over your thighs to push the thighs down gently, very gently here. Aiming at a back that's straight, lower back that's feeling like it's arching. Feel like you're sticking your tailbones towards the back wall so your back isn't rounding. Gently, gently pulling yourself forward, releasing the hips. Keep the jaw soft. Neck soft, and then allow yourself to round the top of your back down. Releasing the grip of the ankles. Walk your hands slightly forward. Let the weight of the head drop your torso further down. Now your back can be round. Walking your hands gently back in. And using the hands to pull the knees towards each other. Gently. Stand your feet on the floor. Pull your knees towards your chest for a moment. And then removing the block, take your left knee pointing to the front and your left foot next to your right sit bone, and then take your right foot over the top of that. So maybe you need to shift and shimmy a little bit to get there. Your both knees on top each other. Right knee on top of the left. Opening your feet a bit so both sit bones can come down to the floor. Put your hands on top of your feet for a moment. Feel the warmth exchanging heat between feet and hands. Like a closed circuit of energy. Few deep breaths, releasing into the hip joints. And then moving your left hand behind your back, right arm over the top. Right elbow behind your back, hands reaching towards each other. Trying to clasp the fingers if possible. If it's not possible, you can use a shirt. Pull on the shirt that you're wearing, or use a belt or a strap to pull your hands towards each other. Roll your head side to side a few times. Stay in the middle with your head. Roll your chin to your chest. Slowly roll your back down. Either your forehead comes onto the knee, or you straighten out through the lower back and you lift the chin over the knee. Keeping the sit bones connected to the floor though. Slowly roll out of this. Release the clasp in the hands. Grab your right foot, knee, pull the knee towards you. Then place the right foot into the crook of your elbow, clasp your hands, rock the baby. Keep the hands clasped, move the ball of your right foot into your hands. Pull the knee towards your right armpit so the knee is still bent, straightening through your lower back, sitting on top of your sit bones. Then gently start to straighten through the knee. And as soon as you start to feel your back rounding, stay there. More important, the back stays straight than that you straighten the knee. Gently, gently, gently straightening more and more. If it's easy to straighten it, then you're still with a straight back. Bend your elbows towards the shin, lifting your leg up higher. And then bending the knee. Clasp your outside of your right foot with the left hand. Sneak your right arm through. Put your knee over your right shoulder. Then sit your right sit bone down. Put your right hand on the floor. And same story here. Make sure you're sitting in front of the sit bones. Start to move towards straightening the leg, but if you feel your back rounding, keep the leg there. Straighten out through the lower back, and then Move towards straightening the leg, twisting your shoulders up. The left shoulder opens towards the ceiling. Gently let it go. Shake your shoulders and legs out for a moment. And then changing sides. So your left foot comes next to your right hip. Sorry, that's your right knee. Your right knee is on the floor below, pointing forward. Your right foot is next to the left hip, and then you grab your left foot to bring it to the same position on top of the right knee. Shimmy a little bit so you can get the knees as close together as possible. And then walk your feet a little bit out, so there's space for both your sit bones to come down onto the floor. Place your palms on the soles of your feet. Relax your hips. Then reach your right arm behind your back. Left elbow over the head, both hands reaching towards each other. Maybe on the second side it's very different. For me it is. Trying to clasp your fingers. If you can't, use a piece of fabric or a strap or a belt. Rolling your head side to side few times, releasing the neck. And then stop in the middle. Drop your chin to your chest, roll your back forward over the knee. Gently rolling back up. Release the clasp on the hands. Grab your left foot. Put it in the crook of your right elbow. Clasp your hands. Rock the baby. Already here, trying to come to a position where you're in front of your sitting bones. Then keep the clasp of the hands, place the ball of your left foot into your hands. Move the knee towards your left armpit first. Shift yourself so you're sitting in front of your sit bones. And then straighten out your lower back, and from there, slowly start to straighten the leg. Keeping a straight, flat lower back, like you're arching your lower back. That's the feeling. As soon as you feel your back rounding, stop there. Very gently straighten more and more and more. If it's very easy for you, start to bend your elbows in towards the shin, pulling the leg closer to you. Then bend the knee. Grab the outside of your left foot with your right hand. Sneak your left arm through. Place your knee, your left knee, on top of your left shoulder. Then put the hand down and sit your sit bone down. start to slowly straighten the left leg. Same story, opening up, almost arching the lower back before straightening the leg. Straightening only as far as you can without rounding the back, gently. Open up the right shoulder to the ceiling. And gently let it go. Let's come to Shavasana. Lying on your back. Your palms opening to the ceiling. Feet flop open. Close your eyes. Notice your breath. Softening your skull, your scalp, forehead, eyebrows, your temples, jaw and your ears and your cheekbones. Nose. Lips. And soft tongue inside your mouth. Chin, throat. Back of the neck. Releasing shoulders, collarbones falling open, shoulder blades sinking down, the upper arms. Elbows, lower arms, your wrists and your hand palms, the backs of the hands, fingertips, sternum sinking up and down as you breathe. Ribs expanding and contracting as you breathe, on the front, on the sides, and the back. Your belly softly lying on your spine. Middle back, lower back, releasing. Front of the hips releasing. Sides of the hips releasing. Your sacrum and your tailbone, pubic bone, sit bones, inner thighs, back of your thighs. The big psoas muscles wrapping all the way from your knees to your ribs. Softening. The whole upper leg hanging. Knees are soft, backs of the knees, shins and calves, ankles, front of the ankles, sides of the ankles, back of the ankles, and the heel bones. Top of the foot, soles of the foot, balls of the foot, all the 10 toes, the whole body sinking, sinking, sinking down. Stay there as long as you like. Thank you very much for joining. Have a beautiful day. See you tomorrow.